Hey, you guys. I just want to give you all an update on the boat. It's well overdue. First, I've gotten a lot of new likes and follows over the past few weeks. Thank you guys so much for that. So, quick update for you guys. My name's Charlie. About a month ago, I had just gotten a boat. It's named the Cetacea. It's docked here in Gulf Breeze. And I had all these great plans to fix it up and then turn it into an Airbnb boat. So basically, before I had a chance to get the project off the ground, Hurricane Sally hit about a week after I'd gotten into Gulf Breeze. So unfortunately, Mother Nature won, as Mother Nature often does, and Cetacea sank during the storm. Alrighty guys, so this is the marina where my boat was tied up at during the storm. As you can see, most of the other boats are gone. There's a couple boats still obviously sitting derelict there, and then they're in the process right now of getting the whole docks rebuilt, but my boat is still at the very end, just underwater. So you know, right after the storm, I got to work trying to figure out like how much it's gonna cost and who I could talk to about getting the boat professionally raised. And guys, it was gonna cost probably at least $6,000 and could go anywhere up to as much as like $8,500, maybe even $9,000. Before I went to go that route, I wanted to at least make an effort to try to do it myself. So with the help of my friends, Chris and Ashley, incredible divers, our goal was to float this thing. And the way we were gonna do it is I had gone to West Marine and I had just like bought all of their inner tubes. I spent probably about $1,000 all like the tow behind the boat tubes, like you try and throw your kids off of or whatever. So we were gonna take those, we were gonna tie them to the bottom of the boat and then inflate them underwater so that they would slowly pick the boat up. As the boat began to rise, we were gonna take a water pump and then pump the water up and out of the boat, effectively bailing it out, helping it come up further. And then I don't know what the plan was, but we were at least gonna have the boat floating. So before we had a chance to even do that, I called the marina owner the night before. I called Scott and I said, "Hey Scott, here's my plan. We're gonna try and get the boat floated. We're gonna try and get it out of here, pick it out of the water, see what's up, go from there." And he's like, that's a crazy plan. Before you do that, you need to call Jeff. So for those of you who don't remember, my buddy Jeff, an amazing guy, amazing friend, amazing captain. He's one of the other Dolphin cruise boat captains here on the island. He was the one who helped me tow the boat here from Gulf Shores in the first place. So I give him a call, not knowing what to expect. And I say, "Hey, how's it going, Jeff?" He says, "Charlie, what's going on, man?" I go, "Well, you know, Jeff, Scott told me to call you about my boat. He said, you know, I don't know why." He said, "Yeah, man, don't worry about it, man. I got you." "What's that mean, Jeff? What's..." I'm worried. I'm stressed. "What up?" He's like, "Yeah, man, don't stress, man. I got you. I got it all taken care of." Use more words, Jeff. So you guys, check this out. So my buddy Jeff, that crazy blowhole, he's got access to a barge with a crane on it, right? So the new plan, you guys, is they're just gonna pick the boat up and out of the water with a crane and then put it onto the barge. Then they're gonna take it to the shipyards of Pensacola. So that's all very good news. I was able to return all the gear I had bought to try and float the boat myself, which was about $2,000 worth of gear. So the very least, that saved me from having to spend all that money to try and float boat myself. It saves me from having to like pick the boat up and out of the water. And it saves me anywhere from $6,000 to $8,000 having it professionally lifted. So that's awesome. I'm super stoked about that. That's all good news. Here's where things get a little more real. So I had a really hard time coming to this decision and a super hard time admitting this to myself. Y'all, that boat's done. So basically, you guys, that boat's been underwater for about a month now. And just looking at some of the outside stuff, it's beyond just stuff that'll buff out. It's effectively become a reef at this point. It's gonna be completely waterlogged the whole way through. Even with its fiberglass, it's gonna be soaking wet on the inside. It's no good. Now that, on top of the fact that I'd have to replace the mattresses, the air conditioner, the stove, the refrigerator, the floor, the ceiling, the lights, arguably almost every single thing on that boat, it's just time to count it as a loss. All right, guys, so here's the good news. I'm a stubborn dude. I'm not giving up on this. Okay, we have to give up on that boat. Hey guys, I know it sounds just like an awful, crappy situation. But honestly, there is something freeing about having decided to just let that one go. It's because by letting go of that, I can kind of start looking more forwards and figuring out what my next plan is. I don't have to be worried about what am I gonna do with the boat, how's it gonna come out, do I know how to fix and repair a boat that's been sunken for a month?
Nope.
So by just letting go of that, I can breathe. And guys, this is one of my favorite parts. This is the best news ever. Y'all have been just absolutely so overwhelmingly supportive throughout all this. So many people have messaged me just their thoughts and their prayers and their kindness. It's really kept me going through this whole thing. But even above and beyond that, I want to thank everybody who donated to the GoFundMe campaign. That campaign was not my idea. I never wanted it. I never thought it was going to have such a major impact, but you guys showed up in spades. Every single one of your names is going across the screen right now. And you guys, it's a total of almost $5,000. Yeah, freaking you guys. That's what the heck, right? Holy crap. And here's I'm just,
guys,
y'all, come on. So guys, $3,550 of that was all the GoFundMe, and there's another $1,200 on top of that that people have put into the pool of belief in me. You guys are crazy, you know that, right? Like, I'm not even this crazy, like, y'all are crazy. I thought that me and my parents were the only ones who believed in me, and I didn't even believe them half the time. All right, you guys, and if you're wondering, like, what's the plan? Where am I going from here? What do I do next? Well, honestly, you guys, I'm already looking for Cetacea too. All right, now it might be a bit because honestly, the dock where the boat's gonna go, it's still under construction. There are still sunken boats, including my own, in the way. So a lot of work has to be done before we can move forward in any direction, because otherwise, if I buy a boat, I'm not gonna have anywhere to put it. But you guys, I promise y'all, I will do my best to keep y'all updated on the whole process. If I start seeing any boats, I might share those with you guys, see what y'all think, get y'all's opinions on them. Thank you guys all so much for watching and staying up to date with this. I really appreciate it. I'll do my better to update you guys too. Yeah, so before I sign off, I just want to encourage y'all to kind of take a look around your situation. And if you have a sunken boat, whatever it looks like, that's anchored you down, you might want to think about just letting go of it. Because as soon as you let go of that, you start moving forwards. So y'all, thank you. Stay happy. Stay healthy. And as always, don't be a blowhole.